Home. It means different things to different people. For the people of Yucca, however, this is home. And what it means has changed dramatically. It looks almost idyllic today. The birds, the abundant plant life, and children playing. This village is now home to these sights and sounds. But it wasn't always this way. Not long ago, there was barely any water at all. People were often thirsty and hungry and very poor. And there was no one nearby who could help. The people and the place have come a long way with some help from friends. This is the story of that journey. Yucca, however, is about as remote a place as can be. In the Anuradhapura district, in the dry zone of Sri Lanka, is a region known by the name Kapitigulava. Getting there means a long, isolated journey into the heart of the country through roads that rarely see traffic. The small community of farmers makes its living off the land, but for 30 years, the people here suffered deprivation and feared for their lives on account of the civil war raging nearby, just to the north of this lonely territory. But even as recently as June 2014, this agrarian community continued to suffer want and hunger for lack of water.
පිරිසුදු ජලය නැතිකම තියන අයගේ උත්සාහයෙන් උනන්දුවෙන් බැරි අයට ගින සුදුන්න සමහර අයකට නැතුවකුත් තිබුණා සිංහවෘපත කියලා ජල ව්‍යාපෘතියකින් තමයි බීමට දුර කතර ගෙවාගෙනකින් ජලය ගෙනත් බීවි
සිංහවෘපත which used to be their only source of water is more than 10 miles away those who didn't have bikes had to walk that distance and back just to quench their thirst something had to be done and urgently.
මුදල් පානීය ජලය නැති කමින් අවුරුද්දකට කොහොමත් 10ක් 12ක් විතර සංඛ්‍යාවක් මේ ගම් ප්‍රදේශයේ අපි ගම්මානේ මිය යනවා වකුගඩු ආසාදන රෝගී සූත්‍ර ගන්න බැරුව. අපි 2014 වර්ෂයේ ජූනි මාසයේ දැම්ම ලංකාදීප පත්‍රයේ මේ ගමේ විස්තර ගැටළු ඔක්කොම.
The people at Access Engineering PLC know lots about water. Seeing this plight, their hearts moved them to do something to ease the burden of those living here. From August of 2014, these highly motivated people adopted Yucca River and formed a corporate social responsibility project. Digging a deep tube well dealt with the need for water to drink. This was installed along with the well to ensure that potable water was delivered to the tank. An elevator tank would also need to be constructed, and it was. To get this done as quickly as importance of the task demanded, they tackled it with system of irrigation and rainwater management and reservoirs played their part. Paddy was harvested in at least one season every year. But time altered many things.
ඉස්සර අපිට ත්‍රස්තවාදී කරදර තිබුණා. අපේ මුතුන් මිත්තන් ගොවිතැන්පත් කරගෙන හිටපු වැව් අමුණු පිටින්ම අවුරුදු 30කින් පස්සේ සම්පූර්ණ කැලෑ වැහිලා විනාශ වෙලා ගියා. අනාථ කඳුළු නැවත එනකොට අපිට ජීවත් වීමට කිසිම දෙයක් තිබුණේ නැහැ. අපි අවුරුදු ගාණක් හේන් ගොවිතැන් තමයි කරගෙන හිටියේ. ගොඩක් දුෂ්කරතාවෙන් තමයි ජීවත් වුණේ. ඊට පස්සේ හේන් ගොවිතැන්පත් කරගන්න බැරි වුණා. මේ පළාතේ වර්ෂාව වෙලාවට වහින්නේ නැහැ. ඉතින් වතුර රැස් කරගන්න තිබුණා. වැව් අමුණු සියලු දේම කැඩිලා කැලෑ වැහිලා කුඹුරු කැලෑ වැහිලා තිබුණේ.
At the receiving end of a cruel 2.5-year drought, they could not pursue their livelihood, with the arid and parched land yielding little. The Kuda Nelugolla, an ancient rainwater collection basin or reservoir, was rendered a dry water hole, silted over and unhealthy for use. The once resplendent agricultural land had been taken over by the scrub jungle.
As an engineer, I think it's a la patra de cala, apegama pedesi avila mahitani apegami, tiena duskarta, mahatu avila balala, taketikali, apegamola, beamer vaturti bunne, eating kumburtika karaganda, vavati bunne, vaturi crest karaganda, visala capi makarla, beamer vatura netimota cavilla, puda duskarta, vavahadala duna, eating apegami. දුප්පත්ම පවුල් 10ක් 15කට ඇත්තටම සැලසෙනවා. දැන් මේ කන්නේ ඉඳලා අපිට ගොවිතැන් ටික කරගන්න පුළුවන්. විශාල සේවයක් කරා අපිට.
Another vital community need was for an irrigation well that would tide over the season of drought, even after the reservoir may have had been depleted of quantities of rainwater. To supply this need, another element was included in the CSR project. The local farmer collective, the Govi Sangvidhane, was delighted to have a huge well and a pump to deliver water which could be used for agricultural purposes. Now, apart from the yearly paddy harvest, it is possible to plant and irrigate other crops such as chili during suitable weather.
මහට බැවේ වතුර ඇති වුණාට යලට අපිට පොඩ්ඩක්වත් වතුර හිටින්නේ නැහැ. යල වැඩ කළා කොහොමදවත් අපිට බලපෑදෙන්නේ නැහැ. අපි වැඩ කළත් බැලුවා. ඒ බලාපුවම වතුර දෙකක් මන්දි වෙනවා. ඒ වතුර දෙකෙන් අලාභය සිද්ධ වෙනවා. මැරුමට ලක් වෙනවා. මේ ලින්ද ඉඳි කරලා දීපු නිසා දැන් මේ යල් කන්නට කුස් බීම් වල අපිට කෙටි කාලෙින් භෝග කරන්න පුළුවන්. පහත් යම් විදිහකින් ගොයම් වල කටයුතු කරලා තියෙනකොට මරුමකට ලක් වෙන දාවොත් ඒත් මේ ලින්දේ වතුර ගහලා ඒ ගොයනුත් අපිට පස්සව ගන්න පුළුවන්. අපි ගොවියෝ වශයෙන් 10ක් 15කට මේ යල් කන්නේ වගා කටයුතු කිරීම සඳහා මේ ලින්ද ඉතාම ප්‍රයෝජනවත් වෙනවා.
The drip irrigation system also gives students lessons they can take home and share, far more than just bricks and steel.
මගේ පාසලට දෙහෙමින් උදව් උපකාර කර පොත්පත් පුස්තකාල පොත් තෑගි භෝග ලබා දී අපහට විශාල කටයුත්තක් කරන ඇක්සස් ඉංජිනේරු ආයතනයේ මාමලාට මම මගේ හදපිරි ස්තුතිය පුද කරමි.
The affection displayed and thoughtfulness expressed can be clearly seen as the friends at Access Engineering spared no pains in providing used clothing to be distributed. Rather than a jumble of used clothing, the extra items were pulled out, laundered, and ironed, and a fragrance was added to the fabric. They were packaged before being handed over to those in most need. These sustainable initiatives, which allow the people of the village to continue the improvements in the village's life, are examples of the thought put into the process by their friends at Access Engineering, showing a spirit that transcends bricks and steel. This is not a story of big buildings and corporations, although Access does indeed have those. This is the story of people helping people. The teams at Access, with lives and families of their own, were touched by the possibility that their expertise could make a difference and help the people of Yakavava build their own bridges to the future. This spirit rides above the whole and seals a friendship and camaraderie that extends well beyond the months it took for the completion of the project. This is not the end. The story continues as we build happier lives and futures together.